Welcome back to Skyrim.
As we left off, kill the boneyard keepers.
Thank you.
dare they cast me from the battle spire?
Thank you. Who's there?
Oh, he fell. Let's try again. Quick save.
Let's kill those keeper things and get back to the prison. You managed to destroy all three keepers? Very impressive. Yes. Please follow me. Keep watch for Durnavir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate.
Is he? He's not fighting back. Why weren't you fighting back? It was
a fighting character.
Come on, she's leading us to the scroll.
Forgive my astonishment. I never thought I'd witness the death of that dragon. Volumes written on Durnavir allege that he can't be slain by normal means. It appears they were mistaken. Unless... the soul of a dragon is as resilient as its owner's scaling hide. It's possible that your killing blow has merely displaced Durnavir's physical form while he reconstitutes himself. Minutes? Hours? Years? I can't even begin to guess. I suggest we don't wait around to find out. Now, let's get you the Elder Scroll and you can be on your way.
Come on, she's leading us to the scroll. The last scroll. Come on, let's take it to Dexia.
Now that you've retrieved the Elder Scroll, you should be on your way. If there's anything I can do before you depart, you must let me know. So my daughter applied some of the lessons I taught her about necromancy, did she? Don't worry. I think I can help you. Your soul essence was trapped inside a gem. When you and Serana entered the Soul Cairn, it was given to the Ideal Masters as payment. You simply need to retrieve the gem. The moment you touch it, your soul essence will be restored. There's an offering altar not terribly far from here. I'm willing to bet that the gem you're looking for is there. Is there anything else? Could be your last chance. I have no choice. As I told you before, I'm a daughter of Cold Harbor. If I return to Tamriel, that increases Harkon's likelihood of bringing the Tyranny of the Sun to fruition. I appreciate your concern. Remember that Harkon is not to be trusted, and promise me you'll keep my daughter safe. She's the only thing of value I have left. Did you have anything to ask before you depart?
Let's go.
It's Braveheart.
Stay your weapons. I would speak with you, Quinarin. Cursed, not dead. Doomed to exist in this form for eternity. Trapped between Laas and Inok. Between life and death. I believe in civility among seasoned warriors. And I find your ear worthy of my words. My claws have rendered the flesh of innumerable foes, but I have never once been felled on the field of battle. I therefore honor name you Quinarin, or Vanquisher in your tongue. Your words do me great honor. My desire to speak with you was born from the result of our battle, Quinarin. I merely wish to respectfully ask a favor of you. For countless years I've roamed the Soul Cairn in unintended service to the Ideal Masters. Before this, I roamed the skies above Tamriel. I desire to return there. I fear that my time here has taken its toll upon me. I share a bond with this dreaded place. If I ventured far from the Soul Cairn, my strength would begin to wane until I was no more. I will place my name with you and grant you the right to call my name from Tamriel. Do me this simple honor, and I will fight at your side as your Graze Mazen, your ally, and teach you my Thune. Trivial in your mind, perhaps. For me, it would mean a great deal. I don't require an answer, Quenarin. Simply speak my name to the heavens when you feel the time is right.
Okay.
The sooner we get the scroll home, the sooner we deal with my...
Because he doesn't have a soul here. Dovahkiin actually wins this match, I wouldn't be too surprised. Except she has a spell where she can actually steal souls from dead bodies. I mean, it could be a question, but no. It's between the last dragon. It's between the chosen undead and the chosen dragon. And the last dragon.
I wish she could come with us.
Okay, I thought there would be a vampire waiting for us. Vampire. Thank you.
I trust your journey was I'm sorry, my friend. I can no longer be of use in this matter. It's my fault. In my haste to read the first scroll, I neglected the careful preparation required. I thought I'd be able to allay the after effects, but I was wrong. Now I am paying for it. Blind? Yes, I'm afraid so. No. It will have to run its course, and there's always the chance I may never recover. No, there is another way. The question is, how much are you willing to risk to find Auriel's bow? I can't guarantee you'd be free from harm. Becoming blind could be the least of your worries. Scattered across Tamriel are secluded locations known only as Ancestor Glades. There's one in Skyrim, in the Pine Forest. Performing the ritual of the ancestor moth within the glade should provide the answers you seek. It involves carefully removing the bark from a canticle tree, which will in turn attract ancestor moths to you. Once enough of the moths are following, they'll provide you with the second sight needed to decipher the scrolls. In keeping with tradition, you must use a specific tool in the Ancestor Glade, an implement known as a draw knife. Every moth priest is taught this ritual, but few ever get the chance to perform it. You should consider yourself fortunate if it works for you. From what I saw in the vision, the Elder Scroll which foreshadows the defiance of the gods with the blood of mortals is the key to the prophecy. Good luck. I hope you find the answers you seek.
I hope we reach Ancestor Glade soon.
No, I ain't going there. Where's my shadow?
This must be the place. Not very impressive, is it?
Nope.
If this ends up being a wasted trip, your friend Dexie and I are gonna have some words when we get back. No one's been here in centuries. I doubt there's any other place like it in Skyrim.
Oh, it's...
It's beautiful.
It's night, so she's saying...
We've got the knife. Now all we need to do is track down one of those tentacles. Hope the moth like that bark as much as Dexie said they would. Look at them. They've definitely taken a liking to you. Looks like we're on the right track.
Can you? Oh. You have to get mobs to attract to me. I didn't even see them.
Whoa. I think that might have been what we were waiting for. Let's head back up there and see if we can read the scrolls.
Blood.
Almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow. I never trusted those damn scrolls. Who knows what those things could have done to you? Just look at Dex again. What about Auriel's bow? Do you know where we can find it? Then it's almost over. We can finally put an end to this ridiculous prophecy. Where is this Darkfall cave? Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down.
Show yourself.
There, he's dead. I passed through here before. Yeah, I did pass through, dude.
Thank you.
Where'd you come from? Done and done.
Be careful. I think we may be in some trouble.
Something.
Done and done.
would anyone want to set up camp here?
You're fine. See, she's fine.
Keep your eyes open.
Come forward. You have nothing to fear here. I am Knight Paladin Gellible. Welcome to the Great Chantry of Auriel. Auriel, Auriel, Halkosh, Akatosh, so many different names for the Sovereign of the Snow Elves. I prefer Snow Elf. The name Falmer usually holds a negative meaning to most travelers. Those twisted creatures you call Falmer, I call the Betrayed. Of course, you're here for Auriel's bow. Why else would you be here? I can help you get it, but first, I must have your assistance. I need you to kill Archcurate Vertha, my brother. The kinship between us is gone. I don't understand what he's become, but he's no longer the brother I once knew. It was the Betrayed. They did something to him. I just don't know why Auriel would allow this to happen. They swept into the Chantry without warning and began killing everyone without pause. The Chantry was a place of peaceful worship. I led a small group of paladins, but we were no match for the Betrayed's sheer numbers. They slaughtered everyone and stormed the inner sanctum where I believe they corrupted Vertha. He's alive. I've seen him, but something's wrong. He never looks as though he's in pain or under duress. He just stands there and watches, as though waiting. Leaving the way shrines unguarded would be violating my sacred duty as a Knight Paladin of Auriel, and an assault on the Betrayed guarding the inner sanctum would only end with my death. Yes, let me show you.
Here's a fun fact for you. I was stuck in this place. I didn't know what to do, but I had to walk into the wall because there was a portal.
This structure is known as a way shrine. They were used for meditation and for transport when the Chantry was a place of enlightenment. Prelates of these shrines were charged with teaching the mantras of Auriel to our initiates.
What's that basin in the center signify?
Once the initiate completed his mantras, he'd dip a ceremonial ewer in the basin at the Way Shrine center and proceed to the next Way Shrine.
So these initiates had to lug around a heavy pitcher of water. Marvelous. How long would they have to do that?
Well, once the initiate's enlightenment was complete, he'd bring the ewer to the Chantry's inner sanctum. Pouring the contents of the ewer into the sacred basin of the sanctum would allow him to enter for an audience with the Archcurate himself.
All that just to end up dumping it out? Makes no sense to me.
It's symbolic. I don't expect you to understand.
So, let's get this straight. We need to do all that nonsense to get into the temple so we can kill your brother and claim Auriel's bow.
I know how it all sounds. But if there was another way, I'd have done it long ago. The only way to get to my brother is by following in the initiate's footsteps and traveling from way shrine to way shrine, just as they did. The first lay at the end of Darkfall Passage, a cavern that represents the absence of enlightenment. There are five in total, spread far apart across the Chantry. Caves? Oh no. The Chantry encompasses far more than a few caves, as you'll soon discover. But before I send you on your way, you'll need the initiate's ewer. Once you've located a way shrine, there'll be a spectral prelate tending to it. They will allow you to draw the waters from the shrine's basin, as if you've been enlightened. This may be the last time we're able to converse. If you have any questions before you leave, I suggest you ask them. Otherwise, all I can do now is grant you my hopes for a safe journey.
All I had to do is go in there. Go touch the wall. Go in there. I didn't know what to do.
That wasn't as unpleasant as I thought it would be. Kind of soothing, actually. I feel a little warmer now. Where'd you come from? Where'd you come from?
Please, I don't want to start over.
That wasn't as unpleasant as I thought it would be.
Oh, you gotta be kidding
me.
Kind
of soothing, actually. I feel a little warmer now.
Oh, great.
Where'd you come from? Wasn't as unpleasant as I thought it would be. Kind of soothing, actually. I feel a little warmer now. Where'd you come from? I knew I heard something. I heard something.
Yeah!
Oh yeah, she's a vampire.
Bye-bye!